Welcome to First Film Vault, the show that gives you random film reviews through my perspective. Now, I know that Valentine's Day was a couple of days ago, but since the romantic in me couldn't pass up this chance, I thought I'd review a film that my lady audiences could enjoy. But not forgetting the other side of the spectrum. Guys, take it easy. I'm pretty sure you'll enjoy this film as well. I've actually mentioned this film briefly as part of my 2012 summer blockbuster pick, and that is Seeking a Friend for the End of the World, which is a pretty long title that I don't mind saying. Now you're probably thinking, wait a minute, Ferry, how is this supposed to be part of FFV's mini sci-fi marathon? Trust me, I got this.
The final mission to save mankind has failed. The 70-mile-wide asteroid known as Matilda is set to collide with Earth in exactly 3 weeks' time, and we'll be bringing you our countdown to the end of days, along with all your classic rock favorites.
Feel free to wear your casual Friday clothing pretty much any day of the week. And if anyone wants to be CFO, anyone?
So, what are you doing with the rest of your life?
Catching up on some me time, find God, maybe move around some chairs.
Maybe I'll run into you on orgy or something.
That sounds nice. Listen, Elsa, you don't have to come next week or ever if you don't want to. It's okay.
You fighting me?
There's just no need. Forget it.
See you next week, Mr. Dutch.
I regret my entire life.
Okay.
Bye. Bye now.
We should set up Dodge with Karen, don't you think?
It's everything I never wore.
The sky is falling.
I've been with a different girl every day. They don't care about diseases. Are you gonna call them back? Or are you related?
You know? No, I don't. I don't.
You don't?
Hello? You okay?
No! I'm never gonna see my family again.
Would you like to come in?
I won't steal anything if you don't kill me.
Agreed.
Now, I've actually checked a couple of websites and most of them had sci-fi attached to this film's genre. But most importantly, so did IMDb. So boom, still counts. Seeking a Friend for the End of the World is a sci-fi drama romance about the end of the world as a giant asteroid is about to hit the Earth and a man finds himself alone after his wife leaves in a panic. He decides to take a road trip to reunite with his high school sweetheart, and accompanying him is a neighbor who inadvertently puts a wrench in his plan. It's directed and written by Loreen Scafaria, which sounded a lot like Safari. She's written for both film and TV before, but this is actually her first time behind the director's chair. And it stars Steve Carell, Keira Knightley, Rob Corddry, Connie Britton, Adam Brody, Martin Sheen, and so on. But most importantly, the pairing of the two leads, which could go horribly wrong, like date night. But that's not the case with this film. So whoever thought up of the idea to pair Steve Carell and Keira Knightley together, kudos to you. I really love the premise of this film and the approach that it took. Most films tend to go too fantastic or too artsy with this subject matter. Melancholia is one in recent memories, but with this film, does not do that. It went with a very mundane and down-to-earth approach that just seems to bring warmth to my heartstrings. I'll admit that by looking at the trailer, you could pretty much tell the ending of the film. But to me, it's the journey to that conclusion that really got me hooked. The different scenarios that happen within this film just seem so human to me. The writing, the acting, pacing, tone, visual, soundtrack, just everything are solid. Although I have to tell you that this is a rated R film, which is understandable since some of the underlying contents are borderline disturbing. It is the end of the world after all. So I'm giving this a ginormous good. It's not gonna win an Oscar or anything, but this is certainly my type of romance film, so I highly recommend it. Even though the apocalypse is kind of a downer for a premise, but the fact that this film is able to steer me to see the lighter, romantic, and heartwarming side of things from the start is a testament of how engaging it is. Thus, appropriate for this Valentine weekend episode, don't you think?
Who's the girl? She the one that got away?
Well, they all got away, but she was the first, yeah.
Let's go find her.
We need to go, right now. If you drive me to where I need to go, I can get you to your family.
Luckily, I'm getting my midlife crisis in just under the wire.
Hi, welcome to Frenzies, where everyone's your friend.
I can't believe you guys are still open.
And do you know what? It's his birthday today.
Why didn't you tell me that? Happy birthday!
Oh, no! Oh, God!
Yeah, we should go.
We are the world to know.
serious?
How fast are you going?
15 miles an hour over the speed limit.
Given the... Couldn't you find it in your heart to give my friend here a fighting chance of being with the one he loves before we all reach our untimely conclusion?
No.
Oh, hi! As you may already know, it's about time for me to skedaddle. How are the chocolates, by the way? Heavenly, I hope. Although, before I officially signed out, there's something on my mind that I'd like to ask all of you, and that is if you'd actually consider this a chick flick or not. So be sure to let me know about it below, or even any sort of comments you might have. You know I always welcome them. And if you like this show, be sure to show us your love and support by subscribing. It's just one click away, so you'll always be in the know as to when the newest episode is being posted and etc. But that's it, folks. I'll see you in 2 weeks, where we'll continue on with more of FFV's mini sci-fi marathon.